Welcome. In this video, I'll explain how to record and edit your F1 highlights videos from the game F1 2011, but of course you can also use it for other games as well. First of all, you need a program called MSI Afterburner. It's free and you don't need to have an MSI video card. I'm not sure though if the program will install if you don't have an AMD video card. Click on Download and Discussion and click on the latest Afterburner beta, because only the beta version supports sound recording. Then unzip and install the program. I assume I don't have to dig into that. So here is the program when opened. It's mainly a program to squeeze some extra performance out of the video card, but we are looking for the video capture function, so I left everything else on its default setting. I click on Settings and then the Video Capture tab. First of all, you have to set a hotkey. As you can see, I've chosen Ctrl and F11. Then you have to choose a compressor. My experience is that MGPG compression works better than RTFP1, and you need to have a sick computer and near unlimited hard disk space to go uncompressed. The next three options, quality, size and frame rate, are important. The higher the setting, the better the quality will be. But if set too high, you may have lower in-game frame rates and it takes a lot of hard disk space. The settings are very high now for the purpose of making this tutorial, but when I'm hosting in F1 2011, I drive with 65% quality, half frame size and 25 FPS. You'll have to test for yourself what works best, but for frame rate I seriously recommend either 25 or 30 frames per second. Any lower is sloppy when watching your video and any higher is hardly noticeable, and I also doubt if YouTube supports it. Then select a folder where to store the file. This can be the same hard disk as F1 2011 is installed. Recording arrays can take plenty of gigabytes, so I wouldn't recommend storing it on a solid state disk. Then the multi-threaded optimization. I left that on automatic since it seems to work fine for me. Of course you want to enable audio. The options of downmixing multi-channel audio isn't really important for me since I play with two speakers anyway, but I left it on. Automatic audio source type works for me, so I didn't change it. But if you don't get the audio, you can test around. Leave this program running and now you can play some F1 2011. When you press the hotkey, you get an icon in the top left corner indicating that it's recording. When you press your hotkey again, recording is stopped and that file is saved. You can record multiple times. The program creates a new file every time you start recording. This can be useful for qualifying, for example when recording the garage would be a waste. Now we come to the fun part, the editing. I assume you already have Windows Live Movie Maker installed, and else you can download it for free from Microsoft.com. Right click on the recorded file and select Open with Windows Live Movie Maker. I'm grabbing the recorded race of yesterday evening as an example, 50% Silverstone. One important thing is to set the closest aspect ratio to prevent black borders around the video. If you're as unlucky as I am and playing with 16:10, you'll end up with black borders anyway, but 16:9 comes closest. You'll see the video appear as a piece of analog film. What we basically do is cut the film strip and throw away the parts that would bore your viewers. The start, of course, is never boring, so we set the first start point around the third red light, giving viewers a bit of time to click full screen and adjust sound. Click right mouse button and set start point. Now we click play and we can watch until it no longer counts as a highlight. Usually I leave the entire first lap in the video. Now you don't have to literally watch it, you can scrub the strip to go a bit quicker. Usually that works pretty fluent in Windows Live Movie Maker, but not right now, since I'm also capturing this. I remember I did an overtake at the first sector in lap 2, so I'm looking for that moment right now. There it was. Okay, overtake done, and the car ahead pulls a gap, so I'm cutting the file here. I click right mouse and split. Now we have two separated film strips like I used the scissor. Now I scrub till the next interesting moment. Ah, that'll look pretty close. So pressing right mouse and set start point. And I pull a gap. So again, right mouse and split. You can zoom in and out on your film strip table on the bottom right by adjusting the slider. This won't have any effect at your final video result in any way. Okay, now I remember a special moment near the end of the race, so I'm gonna look that up. There we have it. Right mouse, start point. Complete confusion about who was to blame for that bump. Pulling a gap here, so setting another split. Of course, we need the moment of the finish. And the final scoreboard. Okay, imagine I'm not pleased with one start point because I actually wanted it to start a bit earlier. Then I add the file again. It will be inserted on the current point. So I start the vid a bit earlier. Click on endpoint, because I don't need anything from that strip that's after this point. And there we have it. Remove the previous part. Else we have it two times. Now it's finished. And what you can do is watch your entire vid to check if you're satisfied with the edit. Let's assume we are, and then we go to save movie and select a preset, or we can create one. Make sure it matches as much as possible with your original file, especially the frame rate. Bitrate sets the quality of your file, but also the file size. Too big and you're uploading a long time if you want to post it on YouTube. Too small and it will be ugly. Around 6000 is pretty okay for half-sized recording, and 8000 will do that for full-size recording, but you can go higher if you want. Then save movie, click your preset, give it a name and a location. Then Movie Maker creates your final video file that you can upload to YouTube. By the way, you don't have to finish the edit at the same time you started it. You can save your editing by clicking on the disk on the top left. Then Movie Maker creates a small file that just describes where you set your cuts on what file. Okay, these are the basics. Movie Maker has a couple of extra options like adding text, music and animations. But that's for you to discover. For a basic highlights fit of a race, this is already enough. Don't be alarmed when Movie Maker seems to be stuck on 99%. That last 1% always takes a bit longer. And there we have it. And we can watch the movie back full screen. And we can upload it to YouTube to share with the others. I hope you do, because I love to see other players' highlights when I participated in a race. And that's the main purpose of this tutorial. I hope it helps you out.